Okay, now I want to talk about tuning and how to tune up the harmonicas so that they play in tune once they're assembled. Now, I've been banging on about this thing called Helmholtz resonance coupling for the past few years. If you haven't heard about it, it's basically the interaction between the resonant frequency of a chamber and the resonance and the pitch of the reed. And for the high reeds, this really can have a very noticeable and negative effect. It can make them play flat. Because on my twin diatonics, your mouth is quite a bit further from the reeds than it would be if you were playing the harmonica straight on there. You've got another, 10, 15 millimeters from your mouth to the reed that has its own resonant frequency. And this can cause flattening of the top notes. So in order to make these things play in tune, you're going to have to tune up some of the top reeds. And this can vary a lot. I mean, on low harmonicas, like down to like a low F and below, you probably won't have to do any retuning. As soon as you get even to a G, you'll have to do a little bit of retuning. And as you go higher, a C harmonica, you're going to have to do quite a bit more retuning. So these things really do work well with harmonicas in the low range, but they can be played perfectly well with higher range harmonicas, as long as you are willing to do the compensatory retuning. So let's see, let me show you how that's done. The first thing you'll want to do is basically start off with a harmonica that's got no cover plates. Okay, so this is my G ProMaster harmonica. You can see it's half valved at the top there, and there's your draw reeds. I'll play it now as is, without with my mouth directly on the harmonica. Okay, now to play it in the switch harp, you don't have to do up the screws or anything. You just basically put it into its slot and put a bit of pressure with your finger behind, and then you'll be able to play the harmonica. Okay, so that's playing in the switch harp. And now here it's playing without it. You can probably hear there's a difference in that high 10 hole. That's with the switch harp and without it. You can actually see that difference with a tuner. This is my battered old tuner that I've had for about 30 years, but it still works great. Anyway, so here's the 10 hole G. Everything looks good. Okay, now as soon as I put that into the switch harp and play those notes, you'll see the pitch goes down. As soon as I get down to about hole number 7, it's fine, but hole number 10, hole number 10 is quite flat. Hole number 9 is a little bit less flat. Hole number 8's getting, it's a little bit flat, and then 7's pretty well back to where it should be. If that was a C harmonica, the effect would be even more extreme. So what do we need to do now? We need to basically retune these reeds so that they play in tune once the harmonica is assembled. Even though this harmonica is half valved, it's still possible to retune the reeds. So here's my little reed probe. I'm putting that in there and lifting up the 10-hole blow reed. Now, there's various ways you could raise the pitch of the reed. You could lift up the valve with a some sort of little thing like this, tweezers, and then scrape away at the end of the reed. That's one way to do it. Another way to do it would be to use something like a little electrical engraving tool. You can get these ones from eBay for about, 15 bucks or whatever. Great little things. So there's a button there, and there's your engraving tool. And that makes life easier because you don't have to apply pressure to the reed. So again, I'm just going to lift up that valve and then do some grinding there. Now, this is very much trial and error, okay? So I've done a little bit there. If I check that on the tuner, it should be quite sharp now. Okay, if I play the harmonica by itself, you can see it's gone up about 2 cents there. But now if I assemble it in the harmonica, let's see what we got. Okay, well, it was down there. You can pretty much calculate just by blowing the harmonica on its own that the amount it raises there will be the amount it raises once you assemble it into the switch harp. So let's just raise that reed a little bit more. So I use the same method, the little probe there, and get my little engraving tool, lift up the valve. You don't need a lot of pressure with these tools. That's the great thing about them. Okay, let's get the tuner back again and try blowing that. So I'm blowing the bare harmonica again. So you can see it's gone up a long, long way. Now, my calculations tell me that once I assemble it in the switch harp, it's probably going to be about there. So let's see what happens. So now it's in the switch harp. I'll give it a little blow. So I was about right. Okay, so to me, that reed is now playing well. Kind of where it should be. So that's hole number 10. Okay, let's see where hole number 9 blow is on the when it's assembled into the switch harp. Okay, it's about A440. I want it a little bit higher. Now this is blowing it while it's unassembled. I want it about there when it's in the switch harp, so I'm going to quickly put a bit of a dab on it. Just check the tuning. Hopefully it's gone up. And I'm going to now put it into the switch harp. See where we are. That's about where I want it to be. Okay, so it's a fairly time-consuming procedure, I have to admit. There's no real easy way around this. You just have to do this for every reed. It seems to affect the blow reeds more than the draw reeds. So if I draw on my hole 10 draw, that's with the bare harmonica, and then I put that into the switch harp and draw number 10. You can see it's very close to being the same. So it's really the blow reeds that seem to suffer from this Helmholtz resonance coupling more than the draw reeds. I don't know why that is, but you will have to put a bit more attention to the blow reeds than the draw reeds. And as I say, if you're using a high harmonica, you're going to find that the detuning is really quite radical. So that was a G harmonica. Let me just demonstrate the effect with a D harmonica, which is really dramatic. Okay, so here's your D harp, and when I play hole number 10, it's about 10-12 cents sharp, and as soon as I assemble it into the switch harp, you'll hear a dramatic lowering in pitch. So it's nearly 50 cents flat. So that's a massive difference. So in order to do that kind of retuning, you're probably better off disassembling the harmonica and tuning the blow reed so you can actually see the reed, and tuning that way. But basically, if you want to raise that reed to A440, you're going to have to raise it by about 50 cents, which is about half a semitone, a quarter tone. If you want to take it a little bit further, you're going to have to raise it another 10 cents or more. So basically the amount that it's below where you want it to be, that's what you have to raise it on the actual harmonica itself, and then do the fine tuning by just slipping your harmonica unit into the switch harp, holding it in your hands like that, and blowing into the hole that you're wanting to check. And that way you can do fine tuning, and then you can get your little reed probe and your engraving tool and do fine tuning that way. But for big tuning changes like that, you're better off disassembling the harmonica and doing the reed plates, doing it on the reed plates first. Okay, well, I hope the principle of this makes sense to you. It's a bit of a faff, but once you've done it, the harmonica will then play in tune. But it's just one of those things, there's no way around it. It's one of those immutable natural laws like gravity, Helmholtz resonance coupling, and it affects harmonicas. As soon as you get a little bit further from the reeds, it's one of those things that affects the tuning. So yeah, I'd recommend using lower keys, and you won't have to do so much retuning. If you're not competent or confident to do the retuning yourself, then the thing to do is give the job over to one of my recommended customizers. They'll make the entire harp for you, and it'll be perfectly in tune when you get it. So that's a great reason. It's Boris Plotnikov doing the Seidel models, Joel Anderson doing the Honers, and Sergei Zhernoshek doing the Suzuki's and Eastop models. They're all fantastic customizers, and they really know what they're doing, and they would have done a lot of these switch harps before, so they know what to look for and how to get it right. Or you can send the harmonica to a good customizer of your choice. Any good customizer will know how to retune reeds, and they'll be able to do the compensation for you. And then, you know, the harmonica will come back to you in tune. But it's not that big a deal. It's not that difficult to retune reeds. There's lots and lots of videos on it on YouTube. So my recommendation would be to teach yourself to retune reeds. But don't teach yourself on a switch harp. Teach yourself on a junky old harmonica that, you can afford to make mistakes on. Because to start with tuning reeds, you'll probably use too much pressure and damage reeds. So make your mistakes on a crappy old harp, and then finally, when you're confident, then you can come and work on the nice harps that'll be inside your switch harp. And talking of nice harps, it's important for the best performance to emboss the reed slots, and also for the switch harp to work really well, it should be half valved. If you want to half valve your harmonicas easily, check out my stealth valves and power combs, which are designed for half valving. So there's some of my stealth valves right there. I've done videos on this already, you can check them out. But you can use standard Hohner combs, Hohner Seidel combs, Eastop Suzuki combs, and you can use normal standard valves to valve them. It's just a little bit more tricky because they don't have valve pockets in the combs to make it easy for you. But if you're smart and clued up, you can easily do it with stock harmonica combs. You don't have to buy special combs. You only need to buy this front unit. That's all you really need to get started to make your own switch harp. Okay, well, I hope that was helpful, and good luck.